happens on the left. Edge of the penalty area. He's into the box now. Ready for a run. Goes for goal. Good save. Salah to force it in. And Liverpool lead in Portugal. Who else but Mohamed Salah on the mark? After the goalkeeper spilled an effort, the Curtis Jones again with this shoot on side policy pays rich dividends. Liverpool take the lead. Mohamed Salah.
Oh, who else? He has just got the knack of scoring goals. It's just brilliant play from Curtis Jones, though. Lovely ball from Andrew Robertson, but it's the run. Then it's the drive into the box. Can you take your mind off? Corona doesn't know where he's going. He doesn't realise.
I do.
Yes, he does ever so slightly, but then Curtis Jones just opens his body up, goes to the far corner. It's poor goalkeeping from Diogo Costa. He has to do better with that. He should even catch it. But then Zaidu is very unlucky. But who else is going to be there? But Mohamed Salah, he's just got this natural instinct of being in the right place at the right time. And another goal for him.
Brilliant from Curtis too. He's looking good. The scouts are in our team.
He's
who's out of his goal, left edge of the penalty area. Allison fires it down to the left wing. Lovely flick by Curtis Jones, extravagant. Back to Mane. Jones again, cutting in from the left, deep inside the Porto half. Support arrives from Firmino. Lovely layoff. Salah runs on. Space for Milner. Milner's cross into the middle. Mane must score, and Mane does. It's 2-0, and it's Sadio Mane. Brilliant cross from James Milner. Low into the area. Porto with nowhere. And Sadio Mane makes it 2.
Well, it's outstanding again from Curtis Jones. He's the one who starts this down the left-hand side with a lovely touch round the corner. But then it's the calmness. Great run from Mohamed Salah. Realises James Milner's outside him. What a ball this is. A bouncing ball to bend it in round the side there. Diogo Costa, he doesn't want to touch it because he's frightened and pushed it into someone's path. What a ball. But credit to Sadio Mane. He reads it. Simple tapping. Two simple tappings tonight for the Reds. I'll take them.
Absolutely. FC Porto nil, Liverpool 2. Sadio Mane, fourth goal of the season. Two poachers' efforts from close range. From Mo Salah and Sadio Mane. Sadio loved that one. Oh. Into James Milner's arms. Nearly has another assist to the Champions League, Stevie.
Incredible. I mean, that is a phenomenal ball. Don't get me wrong, the keeper should probably do a little bit better, but such is the quality. He thinks his defenders are going to deal with it. He thinks there might be an attacker. Puts all the defence and the goalkeeper in disarray, and it's a brilliant ball.
Well, it was a VAR goal check for a potential offside, but there's no way that was offside.
No,
it was a very quick decision by the VAR. 2-0, Liverpool lead here. You can see that when Milner had that ball, Sadio just timed his run, didn't he? He didn't go too early. Great bit of play from Curtis Jones. Such an extravagant flick the way he keeps the ball in play, wasn't it?
Yeah, he's on song tonight, Curtis. He looks in the mood. That goal, the contribution, the first goal's really helped him.
So what a way to end the half then here in the Stadio del Drago. Liverpool in complete control, leading by 2-0. First goal, Mohamed Salah on 17 legs. Curtis Jones cutting inside from left. His shot, spilled by the goalkeeper, Diogo Costa. Ricocheted off Saidu. And then it was both Salah to poach his 7th goal of the season. And just before half-time, Jones to Firmino. James Milner, what a superb cross. Mane from close range makes the half-time score. Porto nil, Liverpool 2. Good through ball over the top. Mane was trying to pick it up. No Salah, he was fouled there, Mane. I think the ref tried to play the advantage. Porto get the loose ball back on the halfway line. They overran it. Brilliantly won back by the outstanding Curtis Jones. Jones is running at them. He's got Mane to his left, Salah to his right. Jones, beautiful play. Salah wants one. Oh. Goal! 3-0! Deadly! Mohamed Salah, Curtis Jones, absolutely brilliant.
Oh, it's clinical from Mohamed Salah. What I said before about Curtis Jones, making the right decisions, picking the right passes at the right times, and this was absolutely perfect. He breaks the play up, then he drives, and now what he's got is he's got options. you like from Mohamed Salah, and that is game, set, match now.
He's scored 29 goals in the Champions League now. And he's one behind Steven Gerrard's club record in the Champions League for Liverpool. And you would not bet against
him getting that tonight. Absolutely not. The way he's playing, the opportunities that we're creating.
8 goals he's got this season, Mo Salah.
He's doing all right.
Wide to the left side, Wendell. Under pressure from Jota. Oxlade-Chamberlain getting involved, trying to press early doors for Liverpool on that far side. Fabinho as well, trying to block them off. Crossfield again up towards Jesus Corona. A little ball in control here at the Estadio de Drago. 3-0. Next game time, Atletico Madrid away in Spain. Oh, Fabinho, another cruncher in midfield, wins it back on a loose pass by Fabinho. 1-1 over the top of Liverpool. Way by Matip. Fabinho can't quite win it, edge of the area. Porto trying to turn. Good work by Coutinho, dangerous looking cross, and they've got a goal back. Cross and a header in by Mehdi Taremi, who pulls a goal back for Porto with 16 left to play. Simple right wing cross, and another header comes in. And that's a bit of a blemish on the night conceding.
It is, but sometimes it's going to happen when you bring so many substitutes onto the pitch. But it's a good ball from Coutinho from this right hand side, just works himself half a yard, gets a lovely ball in, and credit to Taremi because he's been so quiet, he's been starved of any type of service, gets that header, Joe Gomez, it's a magnificent header.
Yeah, unstoppable that one, right wing cross of the Iranian, Taremi pulls the goal back for the home supporters. Porto 1, Liverpool 3. Again, we've created a lot of opportunities here tonight. But it gives the home fans something to shout about for the final 15 minutes. Meanwhile, Jota charging forward on the right, good advantage. He was fouled, play on. Right edge of the penalty area, still Jota. He took too long, but he didn't find a red shirt in the middle. Another through ball for Porto, dangerous this, but the pass, reverse pass of Luis Diaz, slumps the ground in frustration as he tries to get on the end of Torino's pass. He slips out of play on the right side. Stevie Warner correctly pointed out that the home side has heavily watered the pitch and affected them that.
Sure did, thankfully, as the break was on. But you just see with the changes that have come onto the pitch now, there's just that little lack of organisation, that shapes just slightly goes. The problem you have when you bring so many substitutes onto the pitch is they all want to prove a point, so they all want to break forward, they all want to press, rather than just continuing what they were doing so well by retaining the ball and being organised.
Well, that's Aros on the far side for Joe Gomez at right back. Diaz, that's a good tackle by Oxlade-Chamberlain. Better. Now Gomez again at right back, will turn it back to Alisson. He flips it out to his left back, Robertson, who controls on the near side. Feeding now, Curtis Jones. The left back slot in his own half, turns. Well, be careful, Curtis, here. He's back in his own skill to get out of a tricky situation. It's not a bad ball. The keeper's miles out of his goal. And it's slotted towards goal by Firmino. Keeper's not going to get there, is he?
Oh, he does.
Has it crossed the line? It's Jota. Has the goal been given for Firmino? It has, I think. 4-1. The goal has been awarded Stephen Warnock. The goalkeeper's frustrated. He came miles out of his goal. And Bobby Firmino scores. 4-1 to Liverpool.
That's another error from Diogo Costa in the goal for Porto. He comes racing off his line. He doesn't need to. His defender's dealing with the situation. But credit again. Lovely play by Curtis Jones in the fullback position. We thought he'd overworked it. And then Roberto Firmino just creeps past. And then it's a brilliant finish. He's perfect. What an error again from the goalkeeper, because his team were potentially back in the game and had a chance.
Is that the confidence of Curtis Jones now, Stevie?
Oh, 100%.
Last year in a game at Anfield against West Brom, when he's got the ball, and we dropped points there at Anfield, the press run,
and it affected him hugely.
And that moment there, it shows us he's learned from that, because he backed his own skill. It's a great ball down the line for Firmino.
Yeah, it's lovely play from him, because you could see Virgil van Dijk looking at him thinking, hang about, what are you doing here? Where are you going? And again, he backs himself just
to move the ball, move his body and shape it. Well, the fans have been singing the Bobby song all afternoon in the bars like last night, so they get the chance to sing it to him right now because he's just scored.
Yeah, lovely goal for him as well, especially coming into the Manchester City game.
Messi scored for PSG, they lead Man City 2-0. Well, their fantasy football forward line.
It's underway, isn't it, really, because they've been waiting for this. This is what they're desperately after. It's the Champions League.
Gee, he was on the bench tonight.
Shame that he's gone there and sitting on the bench. He's such a great player.
Good for Bobby Firmino's confidence, though. Going on and scoring. Did really well to anticipate that. The goalkeeper, miles off his line.
Yeah, but you've got to execute it.
Yeah.
And he executed it.
He did.
Sort of pinpoint, didn't he? By the millimetre.
Just have to concede it as well.
Yeah, it is. Of course it is. It's very important because conceding the goal, it was going to be dangerous in the latter stages of the game, but again, that just quietens the crowd. It just deflates Porto a little bit.
It's Porto entering the Liverpool half. Good tackle by Joe Gomez. Gomez again. This time just falls over on the far side. Vieira goes to ground. There's still 11 minutes left of this fixture left to play. Porto 1, Liverpool 4. 2 goals for Mo Salah. 1 for Sadio Mane. And Bobby Firmino off the bench after Mady Taremi pulls one back with a header. Takumi Minamino chasing on this near side. Minamino's won it back. Did really well. There goes Curtis Jones again on the left on the acceleration. He's been fouled. The free kick's been given to Liverpool. Curtis will be after a hat-trick of assists now. Yeah, tonight. Man of the match.
Been great. Really has. He's just dominated the ball in midfield. He's been so high in confidence with everything he's done. He was under pressure this season as well. When Naby Keita with Harvey Elliott, Thiago. Where was he going to play? Where was he going to fit in? You need sometimes for that little bit of luck to happen your way. He got that unfortunately with Harvey Elliott's injury. But then he got it again with Thiago picking up that calf injury. Now it's up to him to stay in the team.
Morrison's free kick from the left into Van Dijk in the box clear. Jones hits him a stretch. Firmino's in there and he scores again. And Liverpool are denied the fifth goal this time by Elijah's flag.
And he's wondering how he's offside. He feels like it's ricocheted into his path. It will be checked by the
VAR check. Bobby Firmino swaps it into the back of the net. The VAR checking it to be fair to the referee. Stephen Moore, the free kick comes in. Jota is the one who's offside. But is he interfering? Well, it's deflected off a Porto player.
He looks on time to me.
Firmino and scores. This could be given.
I think it will be. Because he's onside initially and then it ricochets off the defender into his path. I think this is a goal.
Bobby Firmino slotted it in. So still a long VAR check here. And Liverpool scored 5 again in Porto tonight. Is Bobby Firmino got another goal? Referee just waiting for some communication. Referee says, hang on, 1 minute. Still checking it. A long check.
It is a long check, so it must be tight, but
I mean, when the ball's in from Curtis Jones, it ricochets. Firmino is onside. It ricochets off the Porto player into Firmino's path. Stephen Warner, we've got another view. Just talk us through, in your opinion, this.
Yeah, I mean, when you look at it straight away, this is where the level, but then it ricochets off the defender. Then he's offside, but it doesn't matter because it's come off an opposition player, so it falls into Roberto Firmino's path, and then he slots it away. This should be given as a goal.
Curtis Jones involved in it as well. Such a long wait this, isn't it? I don't know why it's taken that long.
It's probably very difficult for the players and the positions that they're in to draw the lines to make sure that they can get it completely right. They do want to be sure of it.
If so, why not just let the ref come over and look at his monitor?
Well, he can't do the lines, so he can't decide on that situation.
There's a long VAR check here. There's some confusion. There's a goal review. It's 4-1 at the moment. It's a goal! Bobby Firmino scores again! 5-1 Liverpool! Now he can celebrate. The famous smile is out. No offside. Stephen Moore, you called it. You got the right decision right. 5-1 Liverpool. We score 5 again.
Yeah,
Porto.
It's a rout, isn't it? It's been so comfortable. But he is an offside. Ricochets into his path and it's clinical. straight away turned to the sidelines and looked and said, it's not offside, I know I'm onside. He was adamant, it took the time to get there, but we got the right decision in the end.
Day for everyone involved at the football club for the passing of Roger. Sir Roger.
Yeah.
And you just feel that it's a performance that the fans wanted to see, and the players have put it in. They were outstanding.
I mean, right from the off, you called it. I'm going to give you credit for this, because if you ever felt this could be a tough night for Liverpool, you didn't. You felt Porto were there for the taking, and that's exactly what happened. You know, one or two people were thinking, oh, to be a full strength side, is it time to rest the likes of Salah, rest Van Dijk for Man City? Jurgen said, no, I'm playing my strongest team here tonight.
Yeah, what a way to go into the Manchester City game. But it's so important that you go in full of confidence, full of goals behind you, and they've done exactly that. But it's just a ground that they enjoy going and playing in.
An exceptional performance from Curtis Jones tonight. From Curtis, it was a great one.
Yeah, really good. It was a really good game from him. I thought everything that he did, composed, organised, kept the ball extremely well. I think away from home, it's so vitally important that you do that, and he did that so well.
I mean, right from the start, well, Mo Salah now, he's one goal away from Renault with Stevie G, scoring the most goals for us in Europe. It's phenomenal.
Yeah, it is. It's just such a good record, but we talk about him game after game. How does he keep up this extraordinary record, these goal-scoring feats that he has? But he gets in the right positions, and he is just so dedicated to his profession.
And in terms of the group, it's a perfect start for us.
Yeah, it's so important that you win the back-to-back games. Win your first home game, that was such an important game. But then go away from home, don't get beat. Make sure that you pick something up on the road. A victory is vital to pick up, and they've done that emphatically.
And Bobby Firmino coming off the bench, you know, he's fighting fit again, and he looks sharp, but Bobby getting a couple of goals, didn't he?
Yeah, and that'll be something that is in the mind of Jurgen Klopp now. What I liked about him when he came on was the deep line positions he picked up, linked up play extremely well, but then also having that threat behind as well.
And it was a good opportunity, wasn't it? You know, in the end, we were cruising this game, you know, with Trent Alexander-Arnold injured. You can take off your likes of Milner, your Mo Salah, your Sadio Mane, can't you?
Yeah, and that's the squad depth as well. That's what you're desperate to do. Even with Trent missing today, you've got James Milner in at right back. He does extremely well. Comes on with another assist in the Champions League as well, but then being able to make their changes, but that only comes after the first 11 allow you to do that.
I know we conceded a goal, but sometimes you can't have it all.
No, you can't.
We've got a goal given by VAR as well.
Yeah, no, that's nice. And the defence and the goalkeeper will be furious that he scored. They won't be happy with that whatsoever.
So a great night. We score five again in the Champions League in Porto. Bobby Firmino, who came off the bench. Sadio Mane with a goal as well, even though maybe Taremi pulled the goal back with a nice header. Brilliant display as well by Curtis Jones in that midfield tonight. You know, what a really sad day for the football club. Mourning Sir Roger Hunt will never be forgotten. The great man would have been proud of that.